Hi, I'm Caitlin Mueller, and I'm faculty here in the Department of Architecture in the Building Technology Program. And I lead the Digital Structures Research Group, and we are focused on ways that geometry and performance can be studied computationally. We're really interested in high performance design. These are all examples of high performance architecture from the past. And in particular, these are all materially efficient. And what's interesting for me about these examples is not only that they are very high performing, but they're also very diverse. They also express a lot of varied and exciting design intent and show that there's a lot of ways that architects and designers and engineers can collaborate to expand the palette of architecture while also understanding and harnessing the power of high performance geometry. This is also really important that we think about this today because buildings and architecture have a huge impact on climate change. In particular, there's operational energy and emissions that cause climate change, but also the energy and carbon emissions associated with building materials themselves have a huge impact on this problem. In this example, the London Olympic Stadium on the right uses only 1/14th the embodied carbon per seat compared to the Beijing Olympic Stadium on the left. And that's due to design decisions that were made by the design team. Too often today, we don't really have a good sense of how buildings are performing, how they're relating to climate change, what their environmental footprint is. And we need to do that during the design process so that we make good decisions to reduce our environmental impact in this really urgent crisis. I'm interested in ways to do this using new tools where we can combine human creativity and design talent with the computational power of tools and generative methods that can aid in, for example, finding very high performing solutions like the ones on the right, but also solutions that are not necessarily optimal, but that blend a hybrid of design intent, human need, and environmental performance, structural efficiency. So one of the ways that I'm working on that recently is by using new emerging methods from machine learning, in this case, deep learning, for example, to compress a really high design space of possible geometries for this long span roof truss and turn it into a human navigatable landscape of high performing designs that are also really different from each other. So in this case, the purple and orange landscape is a two-dimensional latent space that you can click on to find different designs. And you can see that the geometry is varying smoothly, but also fairly significantly. And so for me, these human interfaces are really important. Another interesting interface is the sketch, the kind of most classic analog design method. Are there ways using, again, deep learning that we can link sketches with instantaneous understandings of performance? And then maybe even with the power of suggestion or of combining ideas through things like interpolation. I'm currently working on this research with graduate students in my group. I'm also interested in questions of geometric complexity that emerges from these structurally driven generative processes. So for example, as this spanning structure becomes more and more efficient, you also see that every node becomes different, every member has a different length. Digital fabrication is one way to address this challenge where these structures would be really expensive to build with conventional construction processes. But with digital fabrication, for example, this extruder mounted on a 6-axis robotic arm, it's just as easy to make every node different, to make every member a different length. And in this case, that's driven by structural efficiency. This is a design generated by an algorithm looking to find a really stiff spanning structure. I think it's also really beautiful. And there's something very exciting about using these new fabrication techniques to unlock new, efficient, and expressive structural forms. Another way that we're trying to do this is by looking at the planning processes for these machines, these materialization machines themselves. So for example, in this case, we're building a topology optimized beam or truss structure that spans again. And we have an algorithm that automatically of elements and also all of the instructions for the robotic arm so that that's fast enough so that we can actually use it as a design input. So as we're designing, we can get instant information about how easy or hard it is to build and adjust our design in response to that, in addition to these issues of structural and material efficiency that I'm interested in. Another way that I'm interested in reducing emissions in structures is by looking at unconventional material sources. So for example, here we're looking at tree branches or forks from urban street trees that have been felled due to invasive species. These are really challenging to work with because the geometries of each joint are already given by the tree. So how do we find structures that can use these geometries to create forms that we want to build? computational methods in my group that do this, that given a stock of available material, especially geometrically irregular available material, how do we respond to this with a design proposition? How do we assign this available material to a design intent and modify the design to meet the material we have available? I'm really interested in these processes because they can take pre-programmed geometries that are really intelligent, like tree branches, where wood fibers are optimally oriented in the tree to transmit loads, and directly use them as structural connections in buildings with really beautiful and interesting geometries that tell the story of the material origin. Finally, I'm really interested also in having an impact on practical structures being built today. So for example, in emerging economies in the global south, concrete construction dominates, and flat slab concrete floors have a huge amount of carbon and energy associated with the materials in them. Most of those materials aren't necessary structurally. 75% of the material, the energy, and the emissions by structurally carving away material that's not needed. And we're developing tools in my group to do so that meet building code, that are structurally safe, but are much more lightweight and much less materially intensive. I'm using, in this case, a constrained optimization tool that we developed. And working with partners, for example, with this group in India, we've learned about fabrication methods that are available already and integrated those into our optimization processes so that we're designing efficient structures that are immediately buildable today. We are also investigating the potential of these structures to create new aesthetics as architectural finish on interiors, and also to provide a valuable thermal role, for example, in providing a geometrically tuned thermal mass that improves thermal comfort and reduces operational energy use in buildings. So to conclude, I'm really excited about the potential of new tools for architectural design, and especially in their abilities to improve the performance of the built environment while still promoting and enabling the human creativity that makes our field so exciting. Thank you very much.